up in a hard love town, where everything seems broken in you. You got to believe in something. Believe in me. I believe in you. And when your dreams they forsake you, and you know you can't make it alone, we lift up our voices in harmony. Friendship has a sound all its own. Friendship has a sound all its own.
In a dark room I try to find the light of love in your eyes. Whatever I do is never enough. Why do you have to make it so rough if we can't be together? Set me free, this kind of love is killing me. We've got to find some common ground. Our homes become a battleground. We've got to find some common ground.
Can't you dress like that every day?
Dressing like this would ruin my reputation.
Man, musicians used to wear that stuff like a uniform. You look like a blues brother.
All right, never mind how I look. I want to know how I let you talk me into this.
I ain't talk you into nothing. You lost the bet. Quit whining.
You telling me not knowing the title of one song on the jukebox is gonna ruin my whole life?
Well, getting a scholarship for one of them fancy places in Chicago ain't gonna wreck nothing.
I didn't agree to go. I only agreed to the interview, all right?
Don't mess up your suit.
Don't touch those kegs. I'll grab them when I come back.
I really want you to do well, Stan. I really mean it. It's an opportunity. And I don't remember getting too many of them. Besides, maybe I'm gonna get you out of my hair.
You lie like a rug. What, handling this place without me, you'd be crying all the time.
Go on, get on out of here. Go on.
That's true. Stan, don't leave me.
Very nice.
Well, thank you.
What's the occasion?
Interview.
That's right. The Chicago Conservatory. That's exciting stuff.
That's real exciting stuff.
Stan, there's no way to go to an interview.
What you talking about?
Your heart's not into it. You gotta get mentally prepared. Come on, let's practice.
What, right now?
Right now. Good afternoon, Mr. Lee. What forms of music interest you and why?
My pop's jazz. I was influenced by that. Mm-hmm. Plus, there's a nice mix of sounds here in the Heights.
Sounds?
Yeah, you see, every place has its own sound. You just have to listen for it.
You doing good?
Nah, keep going. I think I'm getting the hang of it.
Okay. It says here you are in a rock and roll band.
Right.
Does that prevent you from expressing yourself in more traditional forms of music?
No, you see, all music tries for the same thing, and that's to tell you a story, right?
Mm-hmm.
So as long as your story gets told, you're fine.
Why should you care how I tell it?
That's a great answer, Stan. But isn't it true that all rock and roll musicians just want to be stars?
You know, I've heard that. But, miss, a star ain't nothing but a ball of gas. You see, stars burn out. That just ain't my style. See, a wise man once told me, he said, you got two kinds of musicians.
Mm-hmm.
You got the ones who want to burn Manhattan down overnight, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then there are the ones who like to keep small fires burning in places like the Heights.
Uh-huh.
I'm more a small fire type, you know? That's what I get being in my band.
And who is this wise man?
My pops.
Well, it sounds to me like you're doing fine right here. Are you sure you want to come to Chicago?
Honestly, I don't know. That wise man told me to keep my options open, too.
You're going to be great.
Thanks. Sure you don't want to get in my pocket?
I'll see you later.
Bye.
I mean, a moment like this, it should only happen once.
God willing, yeah.
So I don't want to mess it up. I want everything to be absolutely right.
I know, you have to woo her.
Woo?
Woo. To woo.
It's a verb.
Part of a courtship. To win a woman's heart.
No offense, Mr. A, but I've been going with your daughter for a few years now. I think the heart thing's pretty solid.
Well, that's different. This is special. You're proposing marriage.
You're right. So, how do I woo?
This is not just any woman. This is my daughter. You must romance the woman. You take everything you've learned as a man and throw it out the window. To woo, you must eat, sleep, and dream romance. You start with the basics, shaving.
Shaving?
When you shave, you gotta shave close. And not just down, but then up again, see, against the natural incline of the whisker. Then you gotta go out and find your proper scent.
Huh?
Hello.
Oh, yeah.
And try them out first. They smell great in the bottle. You buy them, you take them home, the cologne hits your flesh, and poof, you're a skunk.
Right.
And when you ask a girl, my daughter, to marry, you better have the right kind of music. Mel Torme, Louis Prima, Tony, Frank. You don't know buckus about these guys, do you?
No.
Well, you need somebody younger, hipper. I'll tell you what. You go out and buy some Paul Anka records.
Wow. A lot of stuff goes into this wooing.
You have no idea. Have you got a ring?
Oh, sorry, Mr. Ray. I'm going to need the rest of the day off.
That's okay. Now, you just remember.
I know. Shave up.
No. Woo.
Cases and three kegs cross down to Clancy's.
Dennis, Miller time?
We don't make Miller, Scotty. What a surprise.
I'm really sorry about the way things went down.
No, don't worry about it.
Well, it was a little bumpier than how I'd wanted to start things off.
You mean you don't always meet a girl and turn everything upside down? No, I'm joking. Life is getting kind of boring anyway. You sort of liven things up.
Look, why don't we start the whole thing over?
What, from the beginning?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Rita.
Alex. Now, let's go out, you know, on a date. No band, no family, just you and me, alone.
I'd love to.
I'll call you later.
Dead. What's the deal?
How should I know?
You've been paying utility bills for the last 6 months.
Don't make me get up in the middle of this compelling drama.
What the hell did you do?
What kind of mouth you got?
You gambled it away, didn't you? Did you get another hot tip on the dead horse?
Hi. I tried calling, but your phone's out.
Yeah, so I heard. What's going on?
Hey, who's that? The fan club? Tell her to come in. Maybe she'll cook for us.
My father. Real role model, huh?
Well, listen, if the offer still stands, I'd like to work on my song with you.
Ooh. Is this your friend?
Let's do it later at the warehouse, okay? Around noon?
Great.
Problem. leave me out of
it. Get yourself embarrassing me for 5 minutes. What is your problem? Hey, compadre.
Hey, Lenny, what's up, man?
So, Mr. Mazzelli, how does it feel to be robbing banks for a living?
This happens to represent my entire life savings.
Cool. New symbols, right?
No.
You gonna buy me a new cord?
No. It's for a ring. For Jody.
Oh, man, that's great! Congratulations!
Thanks, man, but she hasn't said yes yet. I still have a lot of wooing to do.
Are you kidding? It's a ring, not a house. Look, I've been saving since high school, and I couldn't even afford that with a 30-year mortgage. What a racket.
Ooh, you look down. I couldn't help overhearing.
Yeah, well, what can you do? Excuse me.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! No, I'm not kidding. I mean, it ain't fair. Kid wants to what? Get married, am I right?
Yeah.
Hey, well, you're not being put to death. Would you lighten up?
Jimmy.
Jimmy Gems Bendizi.
Gems? What kind of a name is that?
What's your name?
Dizzy.
Oh, and you're gonna give me a hard time? Dizzy, huh? What, somebody spin you on your head when you're a kid?
Yeah, look, I really gotta go.
Whoa, whoa, come on. Come on, I'm kidding with you. I wanna help you out.
Why do you wanna help me?
Did you grow up here?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. People like us, we gotta stick together.
People like us. Listen, Jimmy, thanks, but I really don't need your help.
Sure you do. And after you check out a few more of those places, you'll believe it, too. Look, here's my card. I sell retail lower than wholesale. You call, you come by, I take care of your good.
Thanks.
No problem. Hey, we gotta stick together.
In a dark room, I try. Find the light of love in your eyes. Whatever I do is never enough. Why do you have to make it so rough if we can't be together? Set me free, this kind of love is killing me. We've got to find some common ground. Our homes become a battleground. We've got to find some common ground. Dare.
Don't I dare what? I liked it.
Are you serious?
Absolutely. Mind if I just try one thing, though?
Not at all.
Now, this would be a completely different way to go, but here's what I do with this song.
All right.
Try to find a lot of love, baby, in your eyes. Whatever I do is never enough. Tell me why you gotta make it so rough. If we can't be together, won't you set me free? Cause this kind of love is killing me. It's like a battleground.
Oh, that felt great. I think you really got something there, Hope.
I must be crazy.
Relax, it's good.
Battleground ruins what I'm trying to say in the song.
Wrong. No. The lyrics are still the same. Now the music makes them bearable. You can't beat people over the head with your message.
You take a song about loneliness, about not feeling like you're enough, and you turn it into a celebration in your groin area.
Isn't everything?
I don't think this is funny.
It's your song. Do whatever you want. I was just trying to help.
And why is that?
Because I'm sick of fighting. It's all I ever do. Because maybe there's a way for you and I to get along and stop acting like we're still in high school.
But see, I don't really trust you, so.
Well, it's just tough luck then, isn't it? I guess everyone can't be as smart and trustworthy as you hope.
Sounds good, buddy. Watching them put him in the ambulance like that, I can't describe it.
He could probably go home tonight, but I'd like to keep until tomorrow just to make sure everything's stable.
Okay, well, is it okay if I talk to him?
Sure, but not too long.
Stan.
Ellis.
Dr. Greg.
Thanks for coming down. It looks like he's going to be okay, but I got to go talk to him, so I'll talk to you later, all right? Thanks, Joe.
Thanks for calling us.
Yeah, no problem.
Is he really going to be okay?
Yeah, he should be. Fine.
And you feeling okay? I mean, you know, the baby.
I'm fine, thanks.
No problem. Listen, I feel like I really let you down, and I was hoping maybe we could talk things over, clear the air. Would you like that?
You know, I gotta get back to work, but I'll talk to you later, okay?
It seems like you're avoiding Miss Jody.
That's true, but, you know, I'm sorry. That's all I'm feeling right now.
Diane Horton, please dial 5216.
I bet you get all kind of respect on account of that suit. Now tell me again. How you told those educated fools about the two types of musicians and the ball of gas? But I probably ate that up.
I'm sorry for not helping out more at the pool hall. I promise I will from now on. Okay.
Stan, I don't plan on building no family tree around that pool hall.
No problem.
Sounds like you really cleaned up on an interview. I got a good feeling about the scholarship, Stan. A real good feeling.
What's going on?
Who knows? Who cares? I don't. That's for damn sure.
Look, what do you want? I'm busy.
Ooh, big man.
You can't wait till I get home to wreck my day? You gotta leave the bar early and make a special trip?
Hey, don't flatter yourself. The rent's due. I need some cash.
What else is new?
Disability check's on hold till I get to the VA up. You have any other questions?
Taking care of this before I went to that damn interview.
Hey, come on. It's not your fault, all right? Your pops is fine.
Don't feel that way.
Hey, come on. I'll help you get this place back together.
Hey, Mike. It's Eddie. Papers closed last night. I got worried. Give me a call.
This is the Chicago Conservatory of Music.
We're trying to contact Stanford Lee to let him know he's been accepted. Because of the late scheduling, he needs to contact the financial aid office first thing Monday.
You did it, man! You actually did it! Oh, man, what?
What am I going to do now? I never wanted to go in the first place.
Hey, I'm glad you could make it. Listen, it's going to be worth your while. So what made you decide to call?
Time. I got to move on this right away. The longer I wait, the less chance I got.
Broads, man. They're tough.
This one in particular is one of the toughest.
All right, here we go. This is the one. I could give it a pitch, you know. It's cut like this, got carrots like that, blah, blah, blah. That'd only scare you. Bing. This is the one, Dizzy.
Jimmy, it's beautiful. I can't afford this.
Hey, what'd I tell you? We gotta stick together. So maybe I'll suffer a little, but it'll work. We'll make it work, kid. Believe me.
Time to break out.
Thank you for being so kind.
Oh, it's my pleasure, Mr. Mike. Now, you just make sure you take it easy.
Now, will you please tell me what's going on with you and Dizzy? Are you planning on getting married or not?
Well, it's still up in the air.
Yeah? So is pollution.
That's right. It's lingering and looming around like pollution.
I've got a confession to make.
Mm-hmm.
But if you try to tell anyone, I'll deny it.
Go ahead. You can trust me.
I like the knucklehead.
Dizzy?
Yeah.
You like Dizzy? So then how come you're always giving him such a hard time?
Well, he reminds me of this cat I knew when I was playing the big band. Never could sit still.
Mm.
He used to pop up all the time, even when it wasn't time for his solo. Dizzy could be his twin. I was always hard on this guy, so he'd concentrate and not pop up all the time. I just figured the same thing would work for Seaman Head. That, and I still think he stole my damn garden tools.
Hey.
Hey.
You don't look like a man who just had a heart attack.
I'm bound by no heart attack. Break me out of this joint.
You got it, man.
Let me sign you out.
You hear anything from that school?
Not yet.
I got a feeling you're going to be going there, Stan. A real good feeling.
Yeah, I know you do, Pa. All right, let's go.
Hey, Stan, don't be treating me like no sick person. I know you.
I know
you ain't going to be babying me. I'm going to tell you that right now.
Okay, Pa, I know. See you. Hold on. Why don't you
sit down? Tell me what's going on tonight.
Funny, I never seem to really enjoy this city unless I'm with someone who's not from here.
Well, it's a pretty place. You're lucky.
Yeah. This is so easy. You know, being close to you feels very natural. Except, I always feel like I'm skipping steps when I'm with you. Like I know more about you than I really do.
Well, I always want to skip steps when it comes to you.
Oh, spoken like a true ladies' man. That's true, isn't it?
Well, I've known some ladies, yeah. I've never known anybody like you either.
So I don't know very much about you, Alex.
I'm just figuring it out for myself.
What's your family like?
Well, I had a pretty good family situation until I was about 6 or 7, and then everything fell apart and my dad split.
I thought, didn't he pass away?
No, well, I haven't seen him since, so I don't really know. But my mother got remarried when I was 15, and I was so pissed, I took off, you know, and partly to get out, partly to find my father, and after a while, I just decided to land here and stop looking. For now, anyway.
Sorry.
He's my father, you know. I just wish I could have spent more time with him.
You are quite a mystery, Alex, so much.
Sometimes, yeah.
But there's more to the story, isn't there?
There's more to every story.
I love hearing you talk. Why are you smiling?
Because I don't usually talk at all.
Thank you.
this one in a while.
It's too long.
Not bad.
For a bunch of dinosaurs.
Don't make me come over this counter.
You and Blakey made some sounds, Pop. You were hip to the extreme.
We played from here, that's for sure. I dug down deep trying to make a new kind of music. I was hoping you'd get something like that in Chicago. Kept this down Boo Hall so you could have that chance. One thing I promised your mother. Make sure you have better opportunities.
I know, Pop. I know.
Here we are at the 17th hole. The woo-woo kid is lining up a magnificent blazer.
Stop it. Stop it. I mean, how many times does a guy propose? It's like, why mess with something you may only do once in a lifetime?
Just once in a lifetime. A man has a moment. Anthony Newley, Stop the World, I want to get off.
You know, these threads are working. I'm already feeling confident, more sure of myself. Have you got any Paul Anka?
So how'd it go in the jewelry district?
Oh, man, I met this guy. He sold it to me lower than wholesale. Check it out.
Whoa. You really did rob a bank, didn't you?
No, it's a great deal. What?
My uncle's an expert.
What are you saying?
Zircons are forever, dude.
Speak English, Lenny.
Cubic zirconium. It's a phony. It's not a diamond, it's a zircon. This stuff doubles for the real thing all the time. It's a fake.
No.
I'm sorry, Diz. I really am.
Right. You're the one who gives me flowers and writes me poetry. What's this?
It's a book.
Book? It's a book full of empty pages.
Well, first you just keep track of symbol things, and then pretty soon you're spilling your guts out. Can I have the same, please? Last night was good.
I had a nice time.
Yeah, me too, and I was wondering if we could do it again.
Well, isn't that what we're doing?
Yeah.
So we're doing pretty good, right?
I know. I just want to get closer.
Look, last night was...
Thanks.
You know, you were there. And I want to go out with you again, absolutely. I mean, I like you very much. I mean, I'm nuts about you. Just go slow.
Just because you got beat on a ring.
Everything has to be perfect. I'm afraid this is going to jinx it.
What happened?
Dizzy got taken to the cleaners.
Not funny.
Battle's more edgy.
It's really good, Hope. It's not my song.
All right, let's just forget it.
Would you two just stop it?
Stan.
Hey, what's happening, guys?
Hey, how's Mr. Mike?
Yeah, I'm sorry about your father.
Thanks, he's gonna be okay. I just came by to tell you that I can't make rehearsal tonight.
Maybe not for a while.
When it rains, it pours.
What's going on, Stan?
Got the scholarship to the conservatory.
I can't believe it.
Stan.
Congratulations.
Oh, Stan, it's a great honor to be accepted to that place. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So, what are we saying here?
Guess I'm saying, I don't know, that I'll be leaving the band.
Leaving?
If I go, yeah.
You sure that's what you want?
I don't know, but that's what my pop wants.
Wait, Stan, you started this band.
Yeah, man, that's true.
And when my parents left, it was the only reason I stayed in this place.
What are you saying, Dizzy? He can do whatever he wants.
I'm saying he shouldn't ditch us.
Yeah, well, it's not your place.
Well, yeah, it is. He's my best friend and my roommate, and I think he should stay.
You're being a baby, man.
I think he should go. It's not your decision, Dizzy.
I can say what I think.
That's just great.
I haven't been this confused in a long time. I just wish I knew what to do, you know? But he's thinking he wants what's best for me, and I'm thinking I already got what's best for me. I really think this is where my dream is, but he don't want to hear that. What he wants for me isn't what I always want for myself. See, when you left, you started trying just a little too hard. He misses you, Mom. We both do.
Why didn't you tell me? I had to learn from Jody. Congratulations, you must be proud. You know, I knew you were dodging me. I had to learn to trust my own instincts.
I just wasn't sure whether or not I was going to accept it.
And?
Still don't know.
Listen. You go to a school like this, you could play your heart out. And you ain't got to worry about nothing but your music. It's like being in a hothouse and the only thing growing is you. You get a degree from a school like this, you don't have to worry about playing the back rooms your whole life.
Yeah, but that was you, Pa.
You want to stay in Heights and do nothing but your life, go ahead. Do whatever the hell you want. Call your 50. What do you got?
Full boat. Kings over sixes. Hey, you guys got to take my seminar. The Many Poker Faces of Jimmy Gems.
Jimmy didn't say nothing about his cousin coming. Let's just go ask him. Oh, there he is. Hey, Jimmy, how you doing? Tell this guy I'm your cousin, please.
Never seen you before in my life. Get out of here.
You lied to me, and you sold me a piece of junk ring.
What do you mean? It's a great ring.
But it ain't a diamond.
So since when did you think you could afford a diamond? Beat it, would you? I did you a favor. That was a great deal. Get him out of here.
Wait, what? Wait. I just want you to know a few things first. I've had a crush on this girl for like my whole freaking life. I must have asked her out 1,000 times, hoping that someday she would say yes. And she did. So now we've been going together for about 3.5 years, and she's pregnant. And I'm going to marry this girl. So this ring you sold me was going to be the symbol of our lives for the rest of time. I give you my life savings so I can own it. Keep it. I don't want your ring. You either give me a diamond or you give me my money back.
Jimmy, you take this kid out right now. I And you give him a real stone. Good luck, kid.
Thanks.
Intelligent woman. I spent 4 years on my own, away at college, getting great grades and grooming myself for law school.
Hope, I know you're smart.
Yeah, well, if I'm so smart, how is it I let J.T. Banks turn me into a psychotic preschooler? What? What's so funny?
Well, it's just that J.T. has always had this effect on you. I just figured that you knew why.
Yeah, no. I know why. I can kick myself.
Yeah, but doesn't it feel better to get it off your chest?
No, not at all.
Hey, girls, what's happening? Oh, I get it. You both had a dirty dream about me, right?
I don't know what it is between us, JT, but I have a feeling if we did figure it out, it would really be something.
Cool. That's cool, Hopi. Mm-hmm. Does this mean we can do your song?
No, that has nothing to do with what I just said. But yes, we can do my song.
Excellent.
Stan! You're here.
Yep.
Oh, I'm so glad.
So are we. Good news all around. Stan's here. Hope says we can do her song.
On one condition. That we dedicate the song to Stan. No matter what you do or where you go, we'll always be here for you.
No.
That's true,
aww.
Stan.
Now, that's the first time I ever heard these two agree on anything.
Yeah. Thank you.
Looks, I'm not staying here to take care of you. Staying here because I really want to, and I'm happy here.
Suit yourself.
But remember what you promised, Mom, about helping to make my dreams come true? Yeah, well, believe it or not, this is my dream. I'm living my dream here. I got a small fire burning, and for right now, that's enough. That's just my style. Please don't be disappointed.
Am I ever sorry I told you that one about the small fire burning? Funny thing is, that's my style, too. Never should have told you none of that nonsense. It's my own damn fault.
I got a baby coming. I gotta start thinking about the future.
Dizzy tries to impress Jody with a new job.
I'd like to pre-apologize for anything I've done or anything I may do in the future.
I love you, you crazy man!
The Heights, an all-new episode next Thursday.
He's got a shiny red nose, big floppy shoes, and a bad attitude. This Sunday, Homie the Clown returns to In Living Color. Then, Rock has a secret. Not just any old secret, but a, oh my God, if Eleanor finds out I'm dead kind of secret. On an all-new Rock Live, Sunday after In Living Color. And tomorrow night, meet three courageous women who banded together to stop an accused rapist. Victims fighting back on America's Most Wanted. Then, see startling new evidence that may prove vampires are much more than just legend. On Sightings, tomorrow on Fox.